Esports Stories presents The Story of LD, Part 2. As David played more and more Dota, his priorities shifted. During the upcoming months, Dota became David's main game, and he took a break from Counter-Strike. The philosophy studies went well, and after the first year of college, David started to work as a writing tutor, helping other students with resumes, cover letters, term papers, and general writing skills. After 4 years of college, David finished his philosophy degree in 2008, graduated cum laude, and moved to New York City to join a program called the New York City Teaching Fellows. After teaching at a New York City public school, David realized that this would not be his future. "I had this idea that it would be fun seeing kids learn and sharing interesting thoughts and information. But a lot of it was making sure that the kids are disciplined, do their homework, and show respect." So, in January 2009, David made the decision to move back to Philadelphia and started to work at Miles Technologies, an IT company with its headquarters in Morristown, New Jersey. David began as a specialist in quality assurance, where he was responsible for overseeing the software development division. Within the next 2.5 years, he changed positions twice within the company and worked as a business software consultant and as a system designer until he decided in March 2011 to start his own business consulting agency. Besides his daily job, Dota was still a huge part of David's life. "I was playing it a lot. As soon as I finished working, I would play for 6 to 8 hours a day." In August 2011, the International was held in Cologne, Germany, and David was fascinated with the tournament itself, the excitement, the game, and the exhilaration that the casters radiated. Toby Wan's hyped casting style got David especially thrilled about the game, and he began to watch a lot of Dota replays. One day, he also discovered the Dota commentaries from Luminous. David educated himself about the professional Dota scene, the game itself, and casting in general by watching replays, other casters, and reading a lot of articles. Not long after, in the beginning of 2012, David decided to give it a shot and recorded his very first Dota commentary under the handle LD, which referred to the comedian Larry David. "I was terrible. I was dry, not knowledgeable. I wasn't funny. It was just a horrible product, really. That's how it started. It wasn't good, but these were the Wild West days." Nevertheless, David kept grinding, and as a huge fan of Luminous at that time, he also tried to reach out to him and ask him for feedback. In the beginning, it was mostly David sending videos, and Luminous not replying, but slowly, Luminous started to see some potential and provided David with helpful feedback. Eventually, Luminous began to see David improving, and he invited David to join his casting group called Dota Commentaries. "Lumi actually told me I should not join Dota Commentaries and rather work with Join Dota and Toby Wan, especially if I want to do live casting in the future. But I liked Lumi. I liked the way he casted, and I looked up to him as a commentator. So I decided to join DC." In the upcoming months, LD and Lumi often worked together. They recorded joint commentaries and uploaded them to either LD's or Lumi's YouTube channel. They were also doing live castings for the Premier League, and David slowly started to make a name for himself in the scene. After being present for only a couple of months, David was recommended by Tusky Atri to David Gods Parker, as Gods was looking for someone who was able to stream the C-Region games at night, as his internet connection was too slow. I think more out of desperation and the fact that he needed someone with a good internet connection, Gods ended up working with me. From the 6th of June 2012 onwards, Gods and LD started to cast every single game of the International 2012 Eastern Qualifiers, which consisted of 14 matches and a total of 1,447 minutes of gameplay. That was the time when I really started to find myself as a commentator. Shortly afterward, Valve was looking for commentators for the TI2 main event, and IceFrog approached a couple of casters including Toby Wan, Luminous, and AC with these words: "I am inviting you to cast the International 2012. Who would you like to cast with?" David's name ended up on Lumi's list, and ultimately, LD was invited to cast the TI2 main event at Key Arena in Seattle, Washington. Luminous and I studied our asses off preparing for TI2. The event went exceptionally well for David, and despite him being new to the scene, he became part of one of the most memorable moments in professional Dota 2 history. The play. If you are not familiar with the term, the play, make sure to check out the short story on this channel. After TI2, David reflected in an interview, "I'd absolutely say it was the most exciting experience I've had so far. Absolutely an honor getting to cast the event. I just felt lucky to be a part of it all." In Seattle, David met his name twin David Parker for the first time in person. And they not only got along really well, but they were also filled with inspiration by the event and had the same vision towards the opportunities Dota 2 online coverage can provide. So, David and David had the idea to build the esports broadcast studio. Beyond the Summit was born. If you want to know more about the beginnings of the company and how it developed during the years, make sure to hit the subscribe button as we will soon be publishing a video about the whole story of Beyond the Summit. In early 2013, David moved from Philadelphia to Los Angeles, California. 2,711 miles and 40 hours of driving later, LD finally arrived in the city. From this point onward, he devoted his energy towards both a successful casting career and being a responsible CEO for Beyond the Summit. "Dota was my life. If I wasn't casting, I was watching, playing, or studying the game." In the upcoming years, David commentated a lot of the popular Dota 2 events, such as the International 2013, MLG Columbus, the International 2014, the Summit 3, the International 2015, the Nanyang Dota 2 Championships, the Frankfurt Major, the Summit 4, the Star Ladder Season 1, the Shanghai Major, and many more. In the course of 2015, David realized that the juggling between running Beyond the Summit and casting was getting harder. BTS expanded, and David found himself without the time to cast and intensively follow the Dota scene in the way that he used to. "I began to focus more on running BTS and less on casting. Gradually, I stepped back. I never really commented on it publicly because it wasn't a eureka moment that happened overnight." Nevertheless, in mid-2016, David was invited to Valve's Manila Major in the Philippines, an event which would change David's life. He randomly ran into a girl named Nina, and they went on a date in Manila. They soon found out that their birthdays not only share the same day and month, but also the exact same year. However, David also discovered that Nina was a League of Legends player and was not into Dota 2 at all. "I joked to her that we would have to cancel the date right there, but really, she was such a wonderful girl and I didn't care." The date went really well. The two quickly fell in love with each other, and about 1 year after their first date, Nina decided to move to the United States and the two got married on the beach in New Jersey. "I love my wife, but she still prefers League of Legends to this day." In August 2016, David attended the International for the fifth time. On the third day of the group stages, LD and Mott casted the match between Alliance and EG together. The game was extremely intense, and after 65 minutes, EG wiped out four members of Alliance without them having a buyback ready. Consequently, EG went for the GG push and was able to bring down both Tier 4 towers. As EG was damaging the Ancient, Alliance would kill Sumail, PPD, Zai, and Fear. Alliance's Ancient only had 5% health left when EG's Universe tried to desperately finish the game. However, EGM on the Ogre Magi stunned Universe with his Fire Blast and once again triggered a multicast. LD was super hyped about the play and shouted, "Ding, ding, ding, motherfucker!" In 2017, David was invited to be a commentator at both the Kiev Major and TI7. But in October 2017, he published on his Twitter, "FYI, I'm taking a break from working Dota events for the rest of 2017 to focus on my personal health and spend more time with my family." After David had posted this statement, the Dota community was confused. Was LD just taking a break from Beyond the Summit, or had he retired from being a caster? The reactions to his tweet were, I'm pretty sure this year won't be the same without you, LD God. Your voice and insight will be missed. Take care. So, in early 2018, LD posted a lengthy statement to clear the air with the community. David explained the journey he had been through over the past 6 years and stated that his focus is on building and growing BTS as a sustainable business. He clarified that BTS is an esports company which had diversified to games other than Dota, but that the Dota community still has their hearts. Ever since Gods and I began this journey back in 2012, the Dota community has shown us incredible support and passion. I know I speak for both of us when I say how unbelievably grateful we are for that. We know we wouldn't be where we are without you. Furthermore, David wrote that he earnestly hopes to sneak in an appearance casting whenever he can, but still realized that this statement might have killed his chances of getting invited to another TI. I have never cast simply for the sake of getting invited to TI, and I never will. At the end of this statement, David gave a shout-out to all the casters and analysts for doing the great job that top-notch Dota deserves. The feedback to David's statement was entirely positive, and we can remain curious as to what David will contribute to the esports scene in the upcoming years. This was the full story of LD. What do you think about LD? Let us know in the comment section below, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. See you next time on eSports Stories.